welcome to another edition of Long Beach Treasures. I'm your host, Harvey Keller. Today we're up here in North Long Beach looking at this beautiful Victorian home, which is the home of Dan and Holly Presburg. Dan, thanks for letting us come up and see your house.
Oh, thank you for coming, Harvey.
What year was this built?
It was built in 1903.
And now this is, it says a dairy
house? Yeah, it was the original dairyman's house for the Long Beach Dairy and Creamery, which moved from here in about 1911 and moved downtown to 4th Street.
So this was actually a dairy farm at one time?
Yes, it was.
Wow. Can we go in and look at the house?
Sure.
Let's go. All right. This is quite an entrance, Dan.
Well, thank you.
How big is your house?
It is about 2,000 square feet.
Oh, that's a good size house. You lead on. Just take us wherever you want to take us.
Well, first, normally what I have people do, because I do open my house up to the public, I have them sign in, so if you wouldn't mind.
I'll be happy to sign in. All right, I'm the first one on that page.
Yeah, they're also the first one for 2008.
Oh, well, good. Which way are we going?
Where would you like to go? Would you like to start downstairs or upstairs?
Why don't we just start here since we're down here?
Sounds
good. This is your entry hall here.
Yes, it is. It's actually, this is not the original. We changed this around a little bit so we had more room for ourselves in the master bedroom, which is down behind this wall. So we've changed it, but you would never know. After living here for so long, you get to learn all the skills of the carpenter. So you get to change things around, you'd never know.
And I bet you had a lot of fun doing the ceiling, didn't you?
Oh yeah, I had a great time. Laying on the top of a scaffolding and coming up with this. The design took me and a friend, it probably took us 20 minutes to design this room. And it took us 5 days, and we were trying to beat the clock in both rooms on getting the wallpaper up around the 4th of July.
You have a lot of antiques, don't you?
I have a few. A few.
And this is the original wood and molding?
Yes, it is.
And I assume the floors are so?
Yes, they are.
Been around for a few years, haven't they?
A little bit over 100.
And this is the dining room?
Yeah, actually, in the old days, this would be the parlor. The front would have been the entrance hall, the sitting room, and you could have had access through two different doors.
Are these pocket doors?
Yes, they are.
Oh, neat. I love pocket doors. It's a nice-sized dining room.
Well, thank you.
Again, much fun on the ceiling, huh?
Yeah, it was great.
Is this the master bedroom?
Yes, this is the master bedroom.
What do you have, a bath down here and a bath upstairs?
Yes.
So there's two baths?
There's two baths.
This is also a nice size room.
Yeah, so this used to be the door to the entryway. And so this would have been, if someone had died, and actually we shrunk down the door a little bit, but if someone had died, this would have been the viewing room, and you would have taken them out there. But the house got switched around, I believe, in 1923 a little bit, and so I changed the door and just took the moldings off, and then recently we put the wall from the front over here, so this is now a closet.
Check out see how big the bathroom is. Oh, this is a nice size bathroom.
It's a work in progress.
You have a lot of wallpaper in this house, don't you?
Oh yeah. Oh yeah, we sure do. But this is, all the door locks work. As a matter of fact, I guess I always carry a skeleton key with me. Just in case I ever get locked out, I always have one.
And we might as well peek in the kitchen here.
Okay.
Now this is not original, the covers look too new.
Well, this part, this is a story. Back here used to be what they would call the water closet.
Oh.
And so what happened here is we had a hot water heater and everything like that. One year it exploded, and took off the back end of the house. And so with the insurance money, I rebuilt the back end over here the way it was, and then also had enough extra because I reworked the wood to put in new cabinets. So these cabinets are only about 15 years old.
That looks like an old stove.
Yeah, it is. It is.
And it works?
Yeah, actually I'm cooking your lunch in it. Or baking your lunch.
All right, now where?
Let's go on upstairs if you'd like.
Okay. Stairs are pretty steep, aren't they?
Yep.
Now, how many rooms are up here?
There are four bedrooms up here. Actually, three and a nursery. Because one's a half-size room that I use for an office.
So this is your...
This is more or less the family room.
You know, I notice a lot of little closets.
Those are all pocket drawers. They all work. They've got different things in them. You know, they've got... In this one, they've got old VCR tapes that I don't use anymore.
But that was just for storage?
That's just like for storage. This is actually another bedroom. And when my son was growing up, he had this room. And the room next door was, quote, the den. That way you could just run upstairs and go without bothering anybody. Yeah. Well, my daughter had the one at the far end.
Is this house hard to heat?
I have actually, the fireplace heats the house.
Oh.
And so what happens is you start the fire at about 5 in the afternoon, you let it run for about 2.5-3 hours, and there's bricks that come through the back part of the house over here, and it radiates this direction.
Well, is that the fireplace in the dining room?
Yes.
These are nice-sized rooms. Do you have a wee baby?
That is my grandson.
Oh.
They live across the street.
Oh, really?
Yeah, they do.
Keep everybody close by, huh?
Yep. Okay.
This is your office?
This is the office. So at the moment, actually I don't have any of my artwork up. I've got one piece back over here, and I'm working on this right now.
For what?
That's for Suja. I took a picture of her and then I cartooned it.
Oh.
So it'll be, eventually it'll be put and matted, and I'll ship it off to her office. So I thought it was kind of fun. We've been friends for a long time, so I just thought that'd be kind of fun.
You're an artist also?
Yes, dabble now. I thought that was going to be my vocation. Actually, I'm a banker now. Banking consultant, I guess you could call me. And, I see Sebastian was here. My grandson was in this room.
Ah.
I can always tell.
See what's outside. Well, you have a nice backyard, don't you?
Yep, that's a lot of fun. Actually, I've got the two plants over here came from Cambria. The rosebush in the very back over there used to be in my front yard. Carol McCafferty gave that one to me, and it is now growing like crazy.
How many garages do you have? Four?
No, I have a three-car garage, actually. It's a big one. So, but it's that was built in 1929, and when I first moved in here, we had to seal off the back end because we had an open hole for where there was a cesspool, I guess.
Uh-huh.
Originally.
Dairy moved, you said, downtown?
Yeah, they moved downtown. They kept the pasture land, from what I understand, all the way around here. Part of it, small part of it's DeForest Park, going back up into the neighborhood. When they subdivided it out, it became the California colony.
Now, there were a lot of cattle farms around here at the time.
There was a couple of dairy farms around here, and there was asparagus and sugar beets over here, too.
Oh.
So this was a farming community at the turn of the century.
Do you know when they got electricity here?
Well, actually, I still have the gas pipes running through my ceiling. So they got electricity, if I recall, around
gas there. Pipe for the gasoliers?
Yeah.
Or for the gas lamps?
For the gas lamps, yeah. So I'm imagining it was somewhere between 1905 and probably 1910. I think most of us were pretty good. This whole part of town wasn't annexed until about 1919, the first time, and then it was re-annexed in 1924 as part of the city of Long Beach.
What was it before it was annexed?
Virginia City.
Oh, is that where Virginia Country Club gets its name?
A lot of people say that that's where we get the name for Virginia City, because it was coinciding, but the Virginia Country Club moved from Rec Park, which is Rec Park now, but used to be over there, and moved over to the Virginia Country Club in about 1924. So at the same time, everything was going on. So I don't know if that's where they got the name from, but maybe.
How did you end up here?
I lived back further in DeForest Park. I lived off of Adair. And I used to come by this house. I used to watch it go into disrepair. Like it was like every 6 months something new would be falling off of it. And so I kept telling my wife, when I we're going to buy that house. Every time we come by it, it's falling apart. I said, I just hate to see that happen. And so one day we were on our way. The kids and I were, and my wife, we were on our way to a play. And we came driving around the corner, and they were pounding in the for sale sign. And so we turned back around, put in an offer. And after a couple of negotiations, we got it for about $100,000.
And that was 25 years ago?
Yeah.
Wow. Good price for...
Well, it's worth quite a bit more now.
Oh, I'm sure it is. And this is a Victorian architecture.
Yeah, it is. It's it's kind of a transitional home. It's got a lot of the Victorian details, but craftsman style is thrown in here a little bit.
Could we run down real quick and look at the backyard?
Sure.
I think your dog is going to serenade us here. Oh, this is a neat place for entertaining, isn't it?
Yeah, it is.
Hi, Nikki. Nice barbecue.
Thank you.
Do you do a lot of entertaining? It looks like you're set up for it.
Yeah, we do probably every year. We, you know, whenever there's an election, we do a candidates forum.
Out here?
Well, between the two. We usually get between 50 and 100 people. And judging by what the next one's going to be this Saturday, it's probably going to be closer to 100, 120. There's a lot of people interested in the school board, et cetera. But, yeah, so we entertain. Every once in a while, somebody wants to do a wedding back here, so we let them do a wedding or two, you know.
This little gazebo looks like a neat little area.
Yep. Watch the landmines.
This would be a neat little place. Little fire pit. The dog knows right where to go.
Yep, definitely. And it's really nice at night when you light it up, it lights up the whole area in the park behind it. So you can actually see the gazebo over the fence.
Wow. Is that new?
This, it's been here, we put it up about four or five years ago.
And what kind of candidate forum are you having?
It will be for the 6th district candidates, the 2nd district school board, and the 4th district school board. So that would be like Felton Williams and John Myers, who are the incumbents, and a couple of other people, and Dee Andrews, who's the 6th district council member, and Amit Zafir.
So he's challenging.
He's challenging Dee.
Be interesting.
It will be interesting, but the most fun is listening to everybody talk about what's going to happen. That's the most fun over here, because you never know what they're going to say, or because they're not really that schooled as yet. Now, Amit and Dee are probably a lot more schooled. They just had an election 10 months ago, so they're prepared, but the rest of them, I doubt it.
Three of the candidates lucked out because they didn't have to run for re-election.
That's true. They sure did.
Hey, that's a good deal. So,
yep.
Well, today's also election day, so... we'll see what happens later on
with
in the
day. Presidents, yeah.
You bet.
All right. Thanks,
Dan,
Harvey.
Thank you for coming, for letting us come over and see your house. I've been wanting to do this for a long time, and John's been after me to get over to do your house, so I finally did. So thank you.
It's my pleasure.
And don't go away, because we'll be right back with more Long Beach Treasures.
The Port of Long Beach is one of the busiest in the country. In case of disaster, being prepared is our number one concern. It's now up to us to be ready for an earthquake, or in the worst case, a terrorist attack. You'll need food and water for 5 to 7 days for your family as well as your pets. You'll need to prepare an emergency evacuation kit for you and your family. For more information, go to www.greaterlongbeachrc.org. Knowing what to do is your best protection, and it's your responsibility.
Food's great. I can see 11 TVs from where I'm sitting. Great atmosphere, good service. Excellent place to come watch a game.
Lots of good sports, great television.
Football, baseball, and HD down at Smooth Sports Grill.
There's actually a nightclub Friday nights and Saturday nights. Fantastic DJ. We love coming to Smooth's.
Great food, got televisions everywhere. Nice place.
Oh yeah, I remember that. Dude, that's hilarious.
Laugh all you want and bring your home to life with Charter Telephone. Get unlimited long distance and the features you want. Call 1-877-SAVE-196 today.
Hello and welcome back to Long Beach Treasures. Joining me now is my good buddy Michelle Bridges, who is an architectural color consultant. And we're here at Edison Place, which was the first electrical homes built in the city of Long Beach. What year, Michelle?
They were built in 1923.
And the style of architecture?
You know, these are a very modest Spanish style. And you can tell this by being Spanish, a lot by the lack of ornamentation, but mostly in the arched windows. And as you kind of take a look towards the top, we've got some clay barrel tiles. We can go ahead and take a walk down the alley,
it
and
looks
I can
like,
show you a little bit more.
It looks like some of the windows have been replaced from the original wood.
You know, yes they have. This lower window right here is original wood, and if you look up towards the second floor, you can notice that that one is a replaced window.
Now this is a unique little driveway that is shared by all of the tenants, and there are 10 units here, right? Two freestanding, and then the others are connected?
Yes, this one right here to my right is an unattached unit, as well as the one over here to the left. And then as you go down the alley, you've got 8 more units, 2 each, that are actually detached or attached units.
Now these all have garages. I wonder if a car of today's size would fit in here.
It might be a tight squeeze, Harvey. And you know, as I was speaking back about the Spanish style, this unit in particular right here has some lovely Spanish tiles on the lower stairway, as well as some saltillo tile. That's something you see very predominantly in Spanish structures, and as well as the arched way at the entrance. One of the other great things about these units when they were built, they had what they called a magnesite stucco applied. And what that was, it was a type of stucco that wouldn't crack, it wouldn't stain, you didn't even have to paint it, and it was supposed to last for years to come. As you can tell, these units have been repainted over the years.
I wonder if it was supposed to be such a miraculous kind of stucco, why it's still not used today.
Harvey, that's actually a very good question, but in doing research, this kind of stucco is actually still used in today's building industry. We have many different types, though, now that they apply. One's called acrylic stucco. It's kind of the same kind of thing. And what they do is they actually apply color into the stucco, so you still don't have to paint it, and it doesn't crack or stain.
So these are probably, what, around 1,200 square feet, do you think?
Actually, they're 1,192 square feet. The majority of them have 2 bedrooms and 1 bath. There are a few of them, though, that have 1.5 bath, and the front unit up here to the left has actually 2 bedrooms and 2 baths. So in terms of if they've added bathrooms throughout the years, we're unsure, but they are very modest and small in style.
Now, these have been repainted because they're all different colors.
You know, these have been repainted, and you know, one of the things as we go through our transition through the years is painting something on the outside always gives it a new fresh feel, and it's what we call, you know, just revitalizing and making it feel good.
You know, with the stucco, it said it doesn't crack, and I don't see a lot of cracks in the buildings.
No, and you know, it's kind of surprising, especially since Long Beach had that large earthquake here in 1933, and 10 years after these were built. So you would think that there would be many, many large cracks, especially being that these are a stucco type building.
Okay, in this unit now, these are all original windows, are they not?
Those wood windows are original, Harvey. They look like they've been upkept very, very well. If you turn around here to my backside, you can see that these windows here have been replaced. These are like an aluminum storefront type window. So you can see the difference of how you have a wood framed window as well as aluminum.
I would assume the floor plan on these are quite similar, if not the same.
You know, I would actually think that the units coming back, these duplexes, probably have floor plans that are actually almost mirror images of each other. The two front units probably have a little bit different floor plan because they don't have an adjoining wall or structure in between them.
Now, when this was built, they sold from $3,000 to $9,000.
Actually, it was $9,000 to $13,000.
Oh, right.
And I would actually think that the ones up probably towards the front, since they were detached, were more of the $13,000. You know, it also had a little bit better view. I'm sure at the time they could probably see the ocean. Well, these coming back down this alley were probably of the lesser in the 9,000 and may have only just had the one bathroom. As you take a look here over the garages, you can see some of the red clay tile barrel roofs, and that's very, very predominant of Spanish style. Also look at some of the ornamentation that they do apply to these homes in the Spanish style with the wrought iron. The windows also do not have any trim around them, and that's something that's also very predominant in Spanish style.
You know, this was quite progressive for all electrical in 1923.
You know, it actually was, Harvey. That front unit that we started at was actually built as a model, and they say that they had 35 working electrical appliances put into that, and they had opened this model for several weeks for several people for the city of Long Beach to come through and tour.
You know, I've tried to think of 35 electrical appliances, and I can't come up with anywhere near. Some of the things that were original here surprised me. One was a dishwasher.
Well, that's true. And they also said they had an iceless refrigerator as well as a range. So it might have been something that they were trying out. You know, I try to think about 35 electrical appliances just in my house alone, and I think if I had every single thing plugged into my house, I still might not have gotten to 35.
Well, I know I don't have 35 in my house. There's no way.
Well, you know, when Harold E. Ketchum, who was the builder and developer, built this one up front, he kind of came in with the city of Long Beach's electrical, and you know, they wanted to display this new electricity for the people in the city. And what they were trying to actually tell everyone is that these new electrical appliances make it so much easier, especially for the housewife back then. It takes away the drudgery of the normal housework with having all this electricity. They didn't have to wash things by hand anymore. They'd probably put something in a washing machine.
I notice a little patio up here, which is sort of neat.
Yes, being that these are sitting right next to each other, they do have little areas that are open. The front unit actually said that it had a covered patio, a sleeping porch, so that area up there might have at one time been considered to be the sleeping porch, but they did not have it covered.
I understand that on opening day here, Thomas Edison sent a telegram to Long Beach congratulating them on being progressive and on the efficiency of the electrical homes.
Yes, he actually did. I thought that was absolutely wonderful. And that was way back in 1923. And you know, there is actually this front unit for sale right now, and being that it was built in 1923, it's been around in Long Beach for quite some time, and I'm sure all the electrical units in there are placed just appropriately, so you can just come in and plug anything into this house.
Now, I know that the one freestanding unit here that we started with supposedly has a basement. I'm going to assume it's a small basement.
You know, it does have a very small basement. Probably houses just the hot water heater. It also has seven rooms to the house, mainly almost all being up on the upper floor. It had two bedrooms, and then it also had, like I'd mentioned before, an enclosed sleeping porch.
I was supposed to have access to both of the freestanding units so that we could show our viewers what they actually look like inside, but at the last minute, why, I was denied entrance. So,
oh,
so we
sorry,
didn't get
Harvey.
To go in. I would have liked to, but I guess that's the way life goes sometimes.
Well, you know, I'm sure if anybody's interested, there is a for sale sign right out here in the front, and they could probably give the lady on the sign a phone call and make an appointment to come on in. And there are actually two units for rent, and they look lovely as you peek through the windows. So I'm sure from that standpoint, if anybody wants to come in and see them, I'm sure they can make an appointment and do that just for themselves.
But it is still a neat little area. You know, Long Beach has a lot of these little hidden away treasures that a lot of people don't know. In fact, I guess we should probably tell the viewers where this is located. It's on First Street between Gaviota and Hermosa. And that it's been here, as you said, since 1923.
Yes, and I find it very interesting that it actually is, it's just its own little alley. It's called Edison Place. It's not even a thorough, a road that goes all the way through. It's just a little niche off to the side here. Very beautiful.
For their entrance to their garages.
Yes, indeed. I'm sure that they use them quite.
Well, Michelle, thank you for taking me on a outside tour of Edison Place and giving me some of the details of its original. You know, electricity came to Rancho Los Alamitos in 1918. And this was built in 1923, 5 years down the line. And maybe Rancho Los Alamitos got electricity later because they were further out than the further away from the downtown area than this would have been.
Well, you know, they did make this as a model specific for electricity. So it was probably something that was new and a new invention. And they wanted to just try something very small to show the residents in Long Beach. And I'm sure that's probably why they were able to go ahead and do this small building.
All right, Michelle, I'll see you soon, and you can take me on another tour somewhere else in Long Beach.
All right, well, thank you so much, Harvey. It's been my pleasure.
Thank you. And that's our show for this time, so be sure and come back next month as we find more Treasures of Long Beach.